LA is fine, the sun shines most of the time. And the feeling is laid back. Palm trees grow and rents are low, but you know I keep thinking about making my way back. Well, I'm New York City born and raised, but nowadays I'm lost between two shores. LA's fine, but it ain't home. New York's home, but it ain't mine no more. I am, I say, to no one there. And no one heard at all, not even the chair. I am, I cry. I am, I say. And I am lost and I can't even say why. Leaving me lonely still. Did you ever read about a frog who dreamed of being a king and then became one? Well, except for the names and a few other changes, if you talk about me, the story's the same one. But I got an emptiness deep inside, and I've tried, but it won't let me go. And I'm not a man who likes to swear, but I never cared for the sound of being alone. I am, I said, to no one there. And no one heard at all, not even the chair. I am, I cry. I am, said I. And I am lost and I can't even say why. I am, I say. I am, I cry. I am myself.
I want to talk about this song. So thank you for listening. This song written by Neil Diamond has a lot of meaning because I am is, there's this story in the Bible where Moses is in the desert and there's this burning bush and he's asking, who is there? Who's there? He hears this voice and he says, who's there? And the bush, the voice says, Hinani. So Hinani has really a deep meaning in the Bible and in the Jewish, definitely the Jewish scriptures. And Neil Diamond is a Jew. And the story that I like to watch most of the time, the movie, is like now we are coming to Yom Kippur. And this is one of the movies I like to watch is The Jazz Singer by Neil. Neil Diamond plays a Jew that's kind of lost and is seeking his identity. He wants to be a singer in LA, and his father wants him to be a cantor in the synagogue. And then he's in love with this woman. So Hinani is a word that it actually appears several times in the Bible, and it comes as a person, a human being is is coming. He's ready to come for an assignment. So maybe I was wrong about the God saying hineni. I think God says yeh asher yeh. He doesn't say hineni. Hineni is actually what a person says when they're ready to take on a mission. So when he says I am, in Hebrew it's hineni. It's kind of it has a deep meaning. So I don't think the story about God saying it is that. But in a Leonard Cohen's song, You Want It Darker, it appears when he sings hineni hineni, I'm ready, my Lord. And that's also a fascinating story that Leonard Cohen, may rest in peace. He died when this was the portion of the Bible. There's a portion of the Bible that mentions this, and it's actually takes us back to, I think it's when God is like telling him, God is this is one of the last songs, and it's it also has the choir of a synagogue in it, and he comes back to his Jewish roots. It's really sad when somebody comes back late in life, like before their death, and all of a sudden they're like, oh, this is who I am. It's so much better when you know it before. So Hineni has a lot of deep meaning in Judaism, and this connects us to these times. So he went through Buddhism, he went through all kinds he mentions Christianity, he mentions Jesus, and then he came back just before his death, he came back to his Jewish roots, and then I think it's kind of a little bit sad and a little bit not sad because he finally found who he was. And I think when you say I am a person, I am, I got it mixed up because the portion in the Bible where the burning bush and Moses asked, who is this? God says, I will be who I will be. Eyeh asher eyeh. And an English translation is, I will be whoever I shall be. And it's like a person, oftentimes a person in life asks himself, who am I? Who am I really? And you see people that find themselves through all kinds of surface identities. I'm a man, I'm a woman. And what I learned from my yoga journey is that we are not the body. We are not, we even have this chant that says, I'm not the body, because our soul is just so much more eternal and so much deeper than a body. I mean, if you believe in reincarnation, it could be a dog, it could be a cat, it can be a human being, it can be a cow, it can be a plant, it can be any of those, a number of things. And it doesn't matter whether you're a man or a woman, actually. It just depends on, that's what I believe. This is my belief. That I know not everybody agrees, that you are who you are, you know? So, person says, I am. It's a declaration. This is who I am. And I don't need to have surgery. I don't need to take hormones. I don't need to do anything. I don't need to put makeup. I don't need to put lipstick on. I don't need to wear high heels. And this is what a lot of feminists are saying. And people, a lot of people, do not enjoy. Do not like what feminists say, but this is it. A woman is not a woman because she has long hair, or because she's has lipstick on, or because she looks a certain way, or whether she has body parts or not. A woman's identity is much deeper than that. And I wish it could be this way. I wish there would be a group of people who say, you know what, I identify as a woman, but I don't need to do all these external things. But sad enough, there's all these transgenders that appear on YouTube, almost all of them. They're just people that feel they need to look a certain way to declare who they are. Instead of just saying, I am, this is who I am to the world, they feel like they have to look a certain way in order to be accepted as a certain gender. And when I think of all the horrific surgeries and hormones that people undergo, and if you say anything against it, you are not even allowed to say anything against it. I feel really sad. I think just singing I am is more powerful than any surgery or anything, because when I sing and I say the words I am the man,
I acknowledge the part of me that is masculine, because we all have, Carl Jung said, we all have a feminine and a masculine side. And when we acknowledge it, we are becoming empowered. And we are flying above all those little categories. And then we really live out the ideals of what the transgenders say they hold, that you can't be whoever you want to be. But in order to be a man or a woman, you really do not have to look a certain way. You don't have to have, you don't have to speak in a certain way. I find sometimes people think to be a man, you have to speak in a certain very rough language. You need to act, look and act rough. You need to dress in a certain style. But actually, a real man can wear a pink t-shirt. A real man can be very gentle with animals and children. A real man can be very soft and gentle, and he doesn't have to be to have a full beard, and he doesn't have to have a mustache, and doesn't have to wear certain clothes. He doesn't have to do anything. He's just the way he is because he's declaring himself to be like that to the world. And the same thing about women. A woman doesn't have to wear lipstick and wear high heels. A woman's identity is who she chooses to be. So this is what I have to say. Thank you, and have a good high holidays again to all the people. And I hope this song was something you liked. It was difficult to make because the cat kept moving around. And at the moment, he quit the cat karaoke. But peace, love, and love. Bye.